Hello guys, LinuxDaily back with another distro review. This is number 3 in the series. We're going to be taking a look at Fedora 27. It is not their latest release. They have released, 28, but it was a beta. But I'm just going to take a look at 27 because I know it's stable. I'm going to click English as my default language during the installation progress. Select my 32 gigabyte hard disk. Alright, I like that. Network and all that is correct. I'm going to click begin. Set my root password really quick. Very secure password. If you look down here, it says the password you have provided is weak. So it lets you know that. But it's a virtual machine, so I'm not going to pay too much attention. Alright, I'm going to create a user named LinuxDaily. Provide another very secure password. And it's giving us the passwords do not match, so that sucks. Alright, now it's telling us that the password we have provided is weak again. We're going to have to press done twice to confirm it. We also have a option to make this user an administrator, which lets you use sudo commands instead of switching to root. But I'm just going to leave that alone. Click that twice, and it is created. Fedora uses GNOME as its main desktop environment, so it's going to be pretty heavy on system resources. I'll get to that when it is complete, but I'm just throwing that out there. You're going to need a beefy computer to run Fedora. This might take a while, so I'll get back to you when it is installed. It appears that it is complete. Fedora is now successfully installed and is now ready for you to use. Go ahead and reboot to start using it. And it gives us a quit option. It would have been nice if that said reboot, but I'm going to click it anyway. The system should be rebooting. I hope. I'm just going to reboot it from up here. Restart. I'm not quite sure why it didn't reboot. Give us an option to reboot. I'm actually going to take out the CD. Then I'm going to reboot the machine. I think it's trying to boot from the CD. Alright, that worked. So I'm gonna go ahead and select the first option, which is your regular boot. And here we go. Fedora 27 is booting. It is taking quite a long time. I don't know what's taking it so long. Alright. I'm gonna select my user profile and type in my very secure password. And it will load the GNOME desktop environment. I haven't played around with GNOME too much, so let's see how this goes. Oops, we're sorry, it looks like boot. underscore image VM Linux. I believe this is a VirtualBox issue, so I'm not gonna pay too much attention to that. English. Alright, good. Typing, I want my English US QWERTY keyboard. You don't need any of this. Keep my privacy. And I will skip, and I will start using Fedora. Getting started. I know how to use GNOME to an extent. This is what GNOME is. See what applications come pre-installed with Fedora itself. Looks like we got boxes, which is a hypervisor. You can run virtual machines with inside it. Calculator, calendar. Cheese is a webcam booth. Clocks, contacts. You get LibreOffice pre-installed, which is quite nice. Files, the GNOME file browser, I would imagine. Firefox is your browser. Rhythmbox is your media player. Under utilities, you get Archive Manager, which lets you handle .zip, .tar files. .zip and .tar files are not the same thing. You get your document viewer, which lets you view PDFs. Terminal, system on. Let's see how GNOME is working. I have 4 gigs of RAM and it is currently using 1.3. It's not terrible, but once we have stuff open, it might affect that. Let's keep continuing to see what comes pre-installed. Videos and weather. What's in the sundry? Problem reporting and SE Linux troubleshooter. That was probably a mistake to open. I'm going to take forever now. I don't need that right now. Alright. This is Fedora. It's quite nice. Let's see what you have for customization. I'm going to imagine I'll be under utilities. Where can I find the settings? I'll just search it up here. Settings. Here we go. There it is. Settings. See what kind of themes and desktop backgrounds we can find. There is no Wi-Fi adapter. Alright, thank you. Background. Click the background and see what we got. We have quite a few good looking backgrounds, I should say. Yeah, these are quite nice. I'm gonna go ahead and select this one. No, I'm gonna select this one. I like this one. That looks quite nice. I'm also gonna select the same for the lock screen, even though that's probably not gonna matter. Details. 4 gigs of RAM, Core i7, GNOME. You could also check for updates here, that's quite nice, instead of doing it through the terminal. Speaking of the terminal, it uses the Yellow Dog Update Manager, which is yum, and for your package manager, so to install packages through the terminal, you're going to want to type in yum-y, install in whatever package you want. So let's see with W3M. Alright, we want to be the root user. I forgot. So I'll switch user. Type in my very secure password. Now we could yum-y install W3M. And it's going to install. The dash y option is pretty much the lazy method to install. If you didn't put that, and just type in yum install, it would work, but it will prompt you if you want to continue, and that just automatically goes ahead. All right, it looks like it's actually an update, so I got the point on that, so. That's fine. Rhythm box. Evolution is your mail client, by the way. This comes with a software center. Quite nice. I do like Fedora. Not many people do, but I think it's quite nice. It's got some games. Super Tux Card is actually quite a fun game. I'm surprised that's on it. It's on the Ubuntu Software Center. So yeah, that's pretty much a good observation here. It looks quite like the Ubuntu Software Center. I do want to find some themes, but I couldn't really find them in the settings. GNOME tweaks, maybe it's in there. All right, that just brought us to the install, so I'm gonna go ahead and install it. Type in my very secure password, by the way. There we go, I'm gonna launch GNOME tweaks right from the software center. Themes, here we go. Animations, you can turn that on and off. You have your global dark themes, which probably make these windows this color, the dark gray right here. It looks like we got some themes pre-installed. Not too many. Looks like you get your standard and then your dark theme. This is giving me a little triangle, so I'm not quite sure what to do about that. Show icons on a desktop, you can turn that off right from here. Let's see what that looks like, by the way. I can go ahead and close the software center. So when you do click that, you get a home and a trash icon, your home folder, then basically your recycle bin. Network servers is if I connected to a file server or something to that extent. I'm just going to keep that off. Background, you could adjust that from here. Your fonts. This is nice. You can include all of this stuff up here in your wing panel. Windows. All right, you have multiple workspaces. I'm not a big fan of this feature. I think it's kind of a useless in my opinion. You just have different windows on the same workspace and you keep them minimized when you're not using them. Works good for me. This is still updating. Don't know how to quite minimize that. But alright, that is a good overview of Fedora 27 Linux featuring the GNOME desktop environment and the Yellow Dog Update Manager for installing packages via the terminal. Comes pre-installed Firefox, LibreOffice boxes, cheese that comes on a lot of Linux distributions. So, yeah. That's about it. That's all I got for you for this episode. If you have a distro you want me to take a look at, leave it down in the comment sections. Other than that, have a great rest of your day.